Most musicians in Southend would agree that if there was any justice in the world, Mickey Jupp would be a lot more famous than he is today. As a songwriter and singer, he's influenced Southend rock far more than anyone.
Juppie was the one that we always held in very high regard because he always played rock and roll.
He's a brilliant songwriter, he's written some fabulous songs.
Jupp's probably the most original character of the whole lot.
Mickey Jupp is one of those people that's always prefixed with the legendary.
Really, Mickey Jupp is unique, really.
Great writer, Mickey Jupp.
He'd be the last to admit it, but without Mickey Jupp, this story would be a very different one.
I like to write songs. I've grown up from playing with model trains. I write songs now as a hobby, and over the years, I've been lucky enough to have made a scratch a living at it. A little bit of success here and there, nothing drastic. But I find that the best songs I've written with me in mind.
Or the ring on your finger, smile and laugh out at me, and I knew I'd lost again, all the rain. Say hello, but don't linger.
Jupp's strengths are twofold. As I say, a great writer and also a great voice. Terrific, terrific voice. And as he gets older, it just gets better and better and better. And for somebody to be almost burdened with being that good a singer and that good a songwriter, most people, it would be too much for them.
Mickey Jupp left the Southend scene in the mid to late 60s. And came back around about 1969 to 70 with a new group called Legend. Most of the bands that were to follow in the few years to follow were all influenced by an album popularly known as the Red Boot album. Didn't really have a title, but it was by Legend, and every track on it was a winner.
He came out of all that influenced from the rhythm and blues, the rock and roll sort of era, and he's one of the few people today who can write songs that fit those kind of artists. So you see, he's like, that's why Ricky Nelson's recorded his songs. That's why the Judds have recorded his songs, because they can relate to what he was doing, and yet he heard that original music in Southend.
Chickens in the driveway, roses round the door, curtains in the window, carpets on the floor. Well, that's all very well, but it's not what I want.
Sometimes they're just, other times you're racking your brains for a day because you've got something to say and you've got two lines to say it in, and it's got to link up with what's gone before and what's coming afterwards, and you've just got two lines to maybe turn the plot round, or this is the punchline, or that is hard work. But yeah, I get to the stage now where I think it'll come, I'll go and do something else. It'll come, you mull it over, you go and play the piano, play it in a different feel. All sorts of things, but it comes, and when it does come, you go, gotcha, next.